what he's going to be. As you can see, really nice stone stuff. Yo, this vlog's going to be epic, son. Yeah, got my hydro. So, I mean, look at this. That's so good. So great. This is awesome. Looks like my cousin went through every expense to do this. And it's gonna be epic. Alright, catch y'all a little bit. So I'm gonna introduce you guys to a nice, beautiful sight that you won't see a lot of. And I'm very happy I'm actually able to get this on my vlog and shit like that. I'm about to take you on the rocks. Hit you some great footage, man. Welcome to Rocky Neck, guys. Look at this. This is what it's about. Plus my family, and I'm gonna get a bunch more footage for this. This is gonna be great. Y'all are gonna love it. I know I'm gonna cry. So if I have it my way, I'm not vlogging that. All right, I'll catch y'all in a little bit. You know what's going on. Later, guys. So we set up my cousin's archway for when she walks down. This is where it's gonna be. And everything leading up to here, where everything's gonna go down. I'm excited for this and everything. Plus, you got the beautiful ocean right behind us. So I took my shirt off, but I'm gonna put it back on. Can't wait to share this with you guys. Can't wait for you guys to see this. Alright, see you in a little bit, guys. Gathering for the wedding and all that. And then if you look over here, you can't unsee that. Creepy man in a Speedo. This is gonna be good. Here comes the bridal party. Train in the background. One running back. This is great. Look at this son of a bitch right here. There's the man of the hour himself. Here we go with the bridal party. And here they come now. There's one cousin. Here comes the youngest. Now for the wedding girl herself. And there's a little flower girl. So cute. As I almost fall. And here we go, guys.
55 to join this man in this holy and holy marriage, which is instances of God, regulated by his fence, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and the honor among all people. Let us therefore reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage and will not marry happiness to mankind. Our Savior has declared that man shall leave his father and mother and cleave unto his wife. By his apostles, he has instructed those who enter into this relation to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, with honesty and industry to provide for each other and for their households and personal things, to pray for and encourage each other in the things which pertain to God, and to live together as the heirs of the grace of life. For as much as these two persons have come hither to be made one in this holy estate, if there be any here present who knows any just cause why they may not lawfully be joined in marriage, I require him now to make a known or ever after the holy king. Friend, I'm going to ask you to bow your head in prayer. Almighty and ever-blessed God, whose presence is the happiness of every condition and whose favor hallows every relation, we beseech thee to be present and favorable unto these thy servants, that they may be truly joined in the honorable estate of marriage and the covenant of their God. As thou hast brought them together by thy providence, sanctify them by thy Spirit, giving them a new frame of heart fit for their new estate, and enrich them with all grace whereby they may enjoy the comforts, undergo the cares, endure the trials, and perform the duties of life together as become a Christian under thy heavenly guidance and protection. Our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Nathan, O to have this woman to be thy wife, and wilt thou pledge thy oath to her in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with her and cherish her according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage.
I do.
Wilt thou have this woman to be thy husband? Wilt thou pledge thy him in all love and honor, in all beauty, in all faith and tenderness, to live with him and cherish him according to the ordinance of God in the holy bond of marriage. I speak in the tongues of men and angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers, and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have and deliver my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. So, faith, hope, love abide, these three. But the greatest of these is love. Mason, please repeat after me. I, Mason, take thee, Megan.
Mason, take thee, Megan.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And I do promise and covenant.
I do promise and covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be thy loving and faithful husband.
To be thy loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
I'm sorry for the shaking, guys.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Megan, please repeat after me. I, Megan, take thee, Mason.
I, Megan, take thee, Mason.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
And I do promise and covenant.
I do promise and covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be thy loving and faithful wife. In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health. As long as we both shall live. Friends, I'm going to ask please if you'll bow your heads in prayer. Most merciful and gracious God, of whom the whole family in heaven is, and earth is named, we pray that you will bestow thy fatherly benediction, granting unto them grace to fulfill with pure and steadfast affection the vow and covenant between you and me. Guide them together, we beseech thee, in the way of righteousness and peace, that loving and serving thee with one heart and mind all the days of their life, they may be abundantly enriched with the tokens of thine everlasting favor. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Mason, what token is it that you bring or promote that you declare here this afternoon? Mason has brought this ring. Friends, I'm going to ask if you can bow your head. Lord, we pray you will bless this ring, that he who gives it and she who wears it may abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor and do their lives there. In Jesus Christ our Lord, amen. And I'm going to ask if you will bow your heads in prayer. Bless, O Lord, this ring that he who gives it and she who wears it may abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor unto their life's end, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And Mason, taking this ring and placing it upon Megan's finger, would you repeat after me? This ring I give thee, in token and pledge of our constant faith and abiding love. Friends, I'll ask you to bow your heads in prayer. Lord, we pray you bless this ring, so that she who gives it and she who wears it may abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor and through their life then, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Placing it upon Mason's finger, would you repeat after me? This ring I give thee, this ring I give thee, in token and pledge,
in token and pledge,
of our constant faith,
of our constant faith,
and abiding love. By the authority that is given unto me by the state of Connecticut as a minister of the Church of Christ, I declare that Mason and Megan are now husband and wife. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace, that peace which the world can't give and can't take away. May the Lord grant you his peace this day. Amen. You may come to God.
And that's that. To be continued inside.
All right, so we got flowers and this amazing, amazing piece right here. And everything. Look at that beautiful cake. Everything. That's beautiful. Everyone's still coming in, so at least the good part, open bar. It's gonna be fun. so happy. Catch you on in a little bit, yo.
How are you doing?
Elliot, nope. No, ours are under 10.
Look at this view. Amazing. Here comes some of the party now. This is all great. Everything. I couldn't be any happier. I love it.
Shannon and Nelson. Kanye and Ryan. Allison and Matt. Cassie and Garrett. Haley and Tim.
Thank you.
Round of applause, everybody. That was great. Now, can you please get ready for the father-daughter dance?
Butterfly kisses at the bedtime prayer. Oh, no. for Megan and Mason?
Child?
Yes. Oh, I can't tell you guys. So for those of you guys who don't know us, I am Cassie, I'm one of Megan's sisters. Alyssa, another sister. Yeah. Wow. When you hear your own voice, it sounds really awful. Yeah. So anyways, we're two of Megan's sisters. We have a couple more, Allie and Gina over there. Yep, there are more of us. Woo! Yeah.
Okay,
so
you were supposed to follow along.
Yeah. You're right there. Well, if anyone's wondering why Megan has two maid of honors,
yeah.
I personally have a lot of theories that Megan probably just didn't trust me to do any of this, or probably just thought that I was going to fail at it by myself.
She did. She actually called me
about a year after she asked Alyssa and said, I need you to step in. Yeah. So, you know, we're here together.
Yeah, honestly. Over the course of this whole thing, I will say, Megan and I usually fight, but we didn't really have a lot of arguments. Like, we really, everything was smooth, and I'm proud of you for that. I'm proud of you for not annoying me. Thank you. Yes. Keeping your shit together.
She did keep her shit together very well.
Yes. But honestly, I think the real reason that she picked us is because, well, let's be real. We're pretty awesome.
We are.
We're pretty awesome. Yeah. At least I seem to think so. No, No, that's okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, in spirit of Megan Mason and their wedding day, I just want everyone to take a moment and reflect on the love and the happiness that they not only bring to each other, but they add to all of our lives. Megan walks into any room and she lights it up with her beauty and her just energy and her vibe. And she's always the life of the party. I mean, she just exudes radiance and beauty and love. And I couldn't honestly think of a more perfect sister to have than you. Obviously, I have so many sisters, which are all perfect, but on this day, we're just gonna say it's you.
She like totally messed me up and like I'm joking. Okay. So I'm gonna go on to Mason now. Mason, my brother-in-law, welcome to the family. We love you so much. And today we get to call you our brother officially. So I just have to share a little thing. When Megan first told me about Mason, I don't know if you remember this, but this is when you first started working at the Black Sheep. And you literally, we were all hanging down in Allie's room one night, and you came running in, and you were kind of, literally like, guys, there's this super hot guy at my work. He's the bar back, and I'm in love with him, and I'm going to marry him one day. I kid you not, guys. So here we are, 7 years later, Mason, officially family. I am so excited, and I know on behalf of my whole entire family, we are just so blessed to welcome you guys, you and your family, so thank you for that. Okay, we're going to choose. All right, so... We would like to ask everyone to raise a glass. It's not every day you find a love like this, but every once in a while, in the middle of ordinary life, love gives us a fairy tale. Congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Flexel. Alright, now Natalie's gonna rock the show.
Save the best for the last, I guess.
Hey, no crying.
Alright, this might be a little deeper than theirs.
Alright,
everybody, my name is Nelson. I'm Megan's cousin, one of Mason's best friends. First off, I would like to thank everybody for being here tonight.
To celebrate a great night for two great special people.
I'd like to thank family, friends, brothers, sisters, aunts, uncles. Without you guys, we wouldn't be here today. To my Aunt Beth, Uncle Troy, Karen, Uncle Joel, I'd like you to thank you guys for raising Megan to be the bright young woman she is today. I couldn't ask for a better cousin or a better sister. Thank you. To Marcy and John, without all your love and support for Mason, he wouldn't be the fine young man he's grown up to be today. I couldn't ask for a better best friend. All of you together did amazing jobs on creating two truly special people who tonight become one. Cheers to you all. Oh, easy here. All right, as for the real reason I'm here tonight, you're not going to hear it. Listen to me talk about me talking. It's about two people, Mason and Megan, and them falling in love. Mason, where do I start? We've been on quite a few journeys together, but this one definitely takes the crown. We're at your wedding, celebrating you and the love of your life, Megan. What can be better than this? It's such an honor to be standing here tonight, speaking at your wedding. It's a memory that I'll cherish the rest of my life. One day, when we're old and arguing about the Patriots and the Giants, we can look back on this special day and laugh and smile. Mason, I couldn't be happier for you. To see you grow over the years into the great person you are today is truly a blessing. Couldn't ask for a better best friend.
Cheers, 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 cheers it up.
Mason, do you remember that night me and you were sitting at Smokey's, probably eating wings, drinking beers? You looked over to me and told me you needed to tell me something. I was thinking, who knows what Mason needs to tell me right now? It could have been anything. When he looked over and said to me, he's like, I think I want to marry your cousin. I didn't really know what to say at first. But I was thinking, like, my cousin found the love of her life. So I turned to Mason and I said, do it. Told him to do it. I felt honored that night, and I'm honored right now. Mason, you hit it out of the ballpark with Megan, and I couldn't be happier for you two. You guys are two peas in a pod. Two of the greatest people I know. You guys are always there for me. If I need a laugh, a little pep talk, things like that is what makes you two perfect for each other. Two old, caring, kind souls. I love you both. There's no words I can express this feeling right now, standing here in front of you and all these wonderful people on your wedding night. It's truly a grateful experience. Mason, my best friend, my brother, you couldn't make me more proud. You did well, kid. Megan, if you can keep track of Mason's keys, phone, and wallet, I think you two will be perfect for each other. Congratulations. Here's to the next chapter in life. Just don't forget, this wedding wouldn't be made possible if it wasn't for me.
My job, dude.
Gotta love the food, gotta love family.
Gotta love everybody.
Megan, Mason, we love you, man. Love you guys.